Chapter 1. Intro.
Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Nicola, your friendly neighborhood smart home geek. Today, we're looking at the SONOFF ZigBee Smart Temperature and Humidity Sensor with an LCD display, SNZB-02D, which I totally impulse bought from AliExpress at 2 a.m. because, obviously, I needed yet another smart gadget. I'll take you through the setup step by step, from unboxing to testing. If you love smart home automation and have an addiction to buying random gadgets, hit that subscribe button and enable notifications so you don't miss future videos. All right, let's get nerdy.
Chapter 2. Disclaimer.
Okay, time for the fine print, except I'll make it fun. This video is not sponsored. No company threw money at me to say nice things about this sensor. I paid for this from my own pocket, which was supposed to be reserved for responsible adult purchases like groceries or electricity bills. Priorities, right? So if this thing is awesome, I'll hype it up. If it's a total flop, I'll roast it like an overcooked marshmallow. Either way, you're getting my 100% honest opinion. Now let's rip into this box and see what we've got.
Chapter 3. What's in the box?
As I already mentioned, I bought this a few days ago from AliExpress for just £10.79. Shipping was free, and it took only 6 days to arrive at my doorstep in the UK all the way from China. Not bad, right? Let's unbox this bad boy. Inside we have a sensor with a gloriously oversized display, because who doesn't love big numbers? A base so it doesn't just roll away. 3M adhesive tape already attached to the base, because screws are apparently too mainstream. A quick guide in English and Polish that I may or may not read. Honestly, I was hoping for a bonus snack, but alas, no free candy from SONOFF. Oh well, at least it comes with a battery pre-installed, so I don't have to go hunting for one in my junk drawer. That's already a win in my book. The sensor has a stand for tabletop use and also a magnet on the back, which can be surprisingly handy. The display is really large at 2.5 inches, which is great for those of us who don't want to squint. I'm genuinely impressed with the build quality and the variety of mounting options. You can place the sensor on a table using the stand, slap it onto your fridge with the magnetic back, or mount the base with the provided 3M adhesive tape anywhere you want and just insert the sensor into the base. Versatility at its finest.
Chapter 4. Add sensor to network.
Now it's time to bring this little data gremlin to life and connect it to your ZigBee network. Here's how to do it step by step using ZigBee 2MQTT. It's easier than assembling IKEA furniture and way more satisfying. Step 1. Pair the sensor. Put your ZigBee coordinator into pairing mode. This depends on what you're using. In my case, ZigBee 2MQTT. Just hit the permit join button in the ZigBee 2MQTT interface. Next, remove the battery insulation sheet to power on the device. Usually when a new ZigBee device is powered on, enters pairing mode automatically. But if yours is feeling bashful, you might need to give it a little nudge. Press and hold the reset button on the back of the sensor for about 5 seconds. You'll see the signal icon start blinking slowly on the screen, kind of like it's nervously waving hello. That means it's ready to pair. Within a few seconds, your sensor should pop up in the device list. If not, don't panic. Take a breath, reset, and remember, you're doing this because you love smart homes. Probably. Step 2. Name it. Unless you're into deciphering long ZigBee IDs, go ahead and rename the sensor in the ZigBee 2MQTT interface. I named mine SNTH Kitchen Fridge. Let me explain the code. SN, short for sensor. TH, temperature and humidity. Kitchen, where it lives. Fridge, where it's stuck. Before smashing that rename device button, make sure to enable update Home Assistant Entity ID, unless you fancy playing hide and seek with your smart devices later. Want to level up your naming game? Check out my video, The Perfect Naming Conventions. Simplify your smart home. Links in the top right corner or down in the description below. Step 3. Fine-tune. Let's fine-tune a few settings so your sensor doesn't end up with an identity crisis. Open sensor from ZigBee to MQTT interface by clicking its name. Feel free to add a snazzy description in the About tab. It's totally optional. I went with temperature and humidity sensor chilling on the fridge. Next, head over to the Exposes tab and choose your preferred temperature units, Celsius or Fahrenheit. Pick wisely. You can also define the upper and lower thresholds for your comfort temperature and humidity. Perfect if you want alerts when your living room turns into a sauna or an Arctic cave. In the Settings Specific tab, you can adjust the precision of each data point. Step 4. Location and labels. Time to bring a little order to the chaos, because even smart homes deserve some structure. Hop over to Home Assistant Settings. Click on Devices and Services from the main menu, and find your newly paired sensor under the Devices tab. Now click on it, and hit the pencil icon in the top right corner to enter edit mode. Assign it a room. Kitchen, bedroom, the fridge of forever chill, whatever floats your boat. Add some labels to make your automation smoother than a freshly waxed floor. When you're done, click Update, and that's it. Your ZigBee temperature and humidity sensor is now officially part of the family. Paired, labeled, placed, and ready to work. Go ahead and pat yourself on the back. Now for the ultimate test. Does it actually work?
Chapter 5. Test.
All right, it's testing time. Now, this is just a sensor, so you're not launching a rocket here, but we still want to make sure it's doing what it says on the tin. You should see live temperature and humidity updates both on the big bold screen and in Home Assistant. To double check, open the sensor in Home Assistant and take a peek at which entities are available. Keep in mind, some of them might take their sweet time to show up. In my experience, the battery level likes to make a dramatic late entrance, sometimes over 24 hours. Compare the readings in Home Assistant to what's showing on the display. They should match. If it says 900 degrees Fahrenheit, either your house is actively combusting or your sensor's got issues. Fingers crossed it's the latter. Want to fine-tune the accuracy? No problem. You can do it right from the device page in Home Assistant settings, or hop into the ZigBee 2 MQTT interface, where you've got not one, but two places to work your magic. The Settings Specific tab and the Exposes tab. Tweak away to your heart's content. Easy peasy data squeezy. So, does it work? Yep, as far as I can tell, this little gremlin is doing its job. Now it's your turn to shine. Start playing with automations. Go wild, but not too wild.
Chapter 6. Final thoughts.
The SONOFF SNZB-02D is compact, accurate, and surprisingly mighty for a sensor that costs less than your last takeaway pizza. Here's what I love. Solid build quality. Big, easy-to-read display. Multiple mounting options. Honestly, it's hard to complain. I've got several of these scattered around my ZigBee network. One has been on duty for over a year and it's still going strong. Battery life? The manual claims 2 years. Reality? I got about a year before needing to swap it. But hey, 12 months on a single cell ain't bad at all. If you're looking for a budget-friendly way to monitor temperature and humidity, or just need an excuse to mess with Home Assistant some more, this sensor is a solid little investment. 10 out of 10. I would stick it on my fridge again.
Chapter 7. Thank you.
If you've made it this far, congratulations. You now officially know more about this sensor than 97% of the internet. Thanks a ton for sticking around. Go treat yourself to a cookie. Or better yet, automate your lights to flash a confetti animation every time the humidity drops. You've earned it. If you enjoyed this guide, don't forget to like, subscribe, and drop a comment below. Whether it's a question, a joke, or just a, hey, I made it to the end. I'd love to hear from you. And if you want to support future smart home shenanigans, you can buy me a coffee, support me on Patreon, or send a one-time tip via PayPal. Every little bit helps keep the lights blinking and the automations flowing. All the links are in the description below the video, right where your mouse is probably hovering right now. Thanks again, and see you in the next adventure. Happy monitoring!